DexLab Analytics. My name is Niharika Rai, and in this particular video I'll be talking about application of ARIMA in Python programming language. If you haven't seen my previous videos on time series analysis or any other videos related to statistics or Python, please go ahead and click on the I icon on the top right hand side corner of your screen and you'll be directed to those videos. If you like this video, please like and subscribe if you haven't already. So without wasting any further time, let's get started. So the time period for this particular project will be from January 1st, 2012 to January 1st, 2017. And the data which we are going to use is will be stock prices and stock prices of Ford, Tesla, GM. So for the same, we are going to import NumPy as NP, import Pandas as PD, import matplotlib.pyplot as PLC, and percentage matplotlib inline to keep the plots in within the parameters of this graph. To further ignore all the errors or the warnings in particular that might pop up, we are using import warnings, warnings.simplefilter, ignore user warning. So in this particular sheet I was having some user warning, so that is why I've used user warning. You can use future warning or multiple warnings, warning ignore quotations for the same. Now for Tesla share prices, I am importing the Tesla from a CSV file, that is by using pd.read_csv and just writing down the path and storing it in variable Tesla. Same I am doing with GM and Ford, pd.read_csv, the path and the variable GM here. And for Ford we are using again pd.read_csv because all these are in CSV format and the sheet is the first one. Now looking at the Tesla dot getting an overview of the data, we see that Tesla dot head has a date column, high, low, open, close and volume. Highest price throughout the day, lowest price throughout the day, opening price, closing price, and the volume traded on that day. And the volume of purchases, not the volume traded. And same goes for GM head. GM, that is date, high, low, open, close, volume. Ford dot head. Again, date, high, low, open, close, volume. Now what we are doing here is we want to set the date column from the Tesla data as our indexes instead of 0 1 2 3 4. So we are writing set underscore index date, that is the date column here, in place true. That means that we are making changes in the original data itself. After that, what we are doing is we are extracting the open column only and plotting a graph labeling Tesla. And this figure size will be 16,8. Title will be open price. GM open, again we are extracting open column and we are plotting and plotting the graph and mentioning GM is equals to GM, which is just the label of the data which we are using. Ford open dot plot Ford PLT dot legend. Now what we are doing here is we are trying to compare the opening price of the shares of all three companies and we are plotting it in this format. So here we have the blue line is for Tesla here, and the orange line is for GM, and green is for Ford. So you see that initially Tesla was at the lowest, but as the date moved ahead, at the time period moved ahead, the Tesla took over GM and Ford here over a period of time. Initially that the highest point was your GM, but later on it came to the second position. Same what we are going to do here now is that we are going to again check for the volume traded. We compare the volume traded overall. So here we have a volume dot plot Tesla titled volume traded, GM volume dot price label equals to GM, Ford volume dot plot again Ford, PLT dot legend and PLT dot show. Show will help us remove the extra line which is here, which is showing here. So we want to remove this extra line and we want to plot just a graph. So here we have Tesla, GM and Ford. We see that the volumes traded of overall the volumes traded of Ford are good. The lowest were of the lowest were of GM here, and Tesla slightly moved ahead in between, and then again we have the Ford being shared here. Now next, what we are going to do is we are going to calculate and add a new column, that is total traded, the amount which we gained from the opening price on that day. So Tesla open multiplied by Tesla volume, so we get the trade total traded value. For total traded value, we will we are again doing the same, open multiplied by volume, and total traded equals to open multiplied by GM volume. Now what next we are going to do is we are going to plot the total traded values of the graph like that. So we have Tesla total traded, GM total traded, and for total traded values here, plt.legend, plt dot y label, total traded, plt dot show. Once we have that, we see that the maximum gain is in we see that the maximum gain is in Tesla only. So that's that, and then we have we can see that they are almost moving together, but actually this the visualization of the same won't give us a very good result. Instead we would rather want a solid result and cross validated by the actual numbers here if we want to, if somebody wants to. Otherwise this is perfect. The moving average part we have already covered in moving average video, so if you haven't watched that, go ahead watch that. But here we are going to talk about ARIMA model. So for that I'm extracting the ARIMA method from statsmodel.tsa.arima model, import ARIMA, and from sklearn matrix has various methods like r square, your mean squared error, your absolute mean squared error, and all that those methods. So we are extracting that, importing that as well. And again, looking at the data, we see that the date is our indexes, is in the form of indexes now, and we have the volume traded. It's in an exponential form. If we extend the decimal points, then we'll be able to see the entire value. So yeah. So here in the length of Tesla is 1258, and columns which we have here is tesla.columns. We get to see all the columns here. Now what we are going to do is we are going to use open value. What should be the open value for a particular period or whatever, like that we are going to use only open column here, and we are going to fill the NaN values if there are any, and fill NA equals to value equals to Tesla open dot mean. So we are filling all the NaN values with, instead of zero, we are filling it with the mean of the original data itself. So the column has mean, and in place equals to true, that means we are trying to make the changes in the original data itself. Now again, resetting the data, resetting the test data here, resetting the data here by changing the indexes to the 0, 1 and 2 format. Tesla.reset_reset_index drop equals to true. So we are dropping the original index, that is the date column, and we are only using the 0, 1, 2, 3 index as that. In place again equals to true, that means we are making the changes in the original data. Now what we have to do is we have to use the ARIMA method which we have just imported, and here we have ARIMA, and we are calling out the column. In case there are any NaN values, we are also extending the method, the we are extending or using the fill NaN method in case if we haven't already. So, and we are using the order of 1:1:1 model. That means that P is 1, your Q is, sorry, D is 1 and Q is 1. autocorrelation or autoregression is one, and differencing we are doing it by one, and moving average is also one. The past errors of one period are going to be added in the original data so that we get the result as so. Once we have this, we have stored it in a variable model, and we see that we have model underscore fit here, another variable, and wherein we are using that fit method so that the open method is fitted over the model itself. So what happens is that in machine learning we do multi-step, we follow multi-steps. That is, once first we call the data, and then we fit the data, and then we are checking for the parameters here. So what are the parameters that have been calculated with 1:1:1 model? So once we run that, we see that the AR, that is autoregression part, we get 0.432264 as our autoregression value. We have the constant term as 0.029849, and our moving average error is this -0.478329, and the data type is float here. Now if you want to predict what should be the future value of the data, so what you can do is you can use model. We have stored the model in model underscore fit. We have shown the data to the model underscore fit variable, or the model ARIMA model itself. So what we can do is we can use model underscore fit dot predict type levels equals type equals to levels. Now if we do not use levels, by default it gives us the result in decimal format, so we don't want it in decimal format. That is why we are using type equals to levels here, and predict dot model dot fit, and we are storing whatever the predictions we have made here in X. So here what we are doing is, since we all know that the original in normal time series data sets, the dependent variable itself predicts itself. So we are not using any outside variables here or outside data here. We are just saying that we have shown the ARIMA model some our data. Now I want to predict my values on the basis of this by using the same data here. So type equals to levels, print X. So here are the predictions. Using predict method, we are able to predict the values. So what happens is that, suppose that we have 5.70 in our second place. So what it does is that it actually predicts itself. The data is predicting itself only. So here at second position we got 5.679 or something like that. So now what we can do is we can check if there is a difference between the original value of the second index and this particular value itself. So that's that. Now what we can do is we can forecast this value and draw a graph as well. So we have model underscore predict starting from the 1000th value. Now instead of taking the predictions entirely, what we are doing is from the second index, instead of that we are using the second 1000 index, the index number 1000 from where the predictions are going to be made, again using type levels here and storing that data in Tesla forecast. Okay, now what we are doing is we are plotting the same graph. So we are calling the open column, we are calling the forecast column, and we are plotting the same on one top of the other. So what is happening here is that we get a graph like so, wherein we see that the orange part is the forecast value and the blue part is the original data itself. So we in graphical format we see that there is not much difference in the actual values and the observed values and the predicted values. But again, I would say that this is not the reality. You must go ahead and check for the mean squared error or the errors so that you get the exact data result, whether you're over predicting or under predicting your data. So for that, again what we are doing here is we are using mean underscore squared error, Tesla quotations open, square bracket, from the second index, since the predictions, original predictions of the X data have been from the second index, we are taking that, comma, the prediction. So we are comparing the original data from the second index and using the x data we have already, which we have already predicted to calculate the mean squared error. So we get a result of 1.119 and so on and so forth. So that means that the mean squared error should be 0 in case which basically means that we have predicted the result, we have 100% of accuracy. If the result is negative, that means we have under predicted, and if the result is in positive form, then that means that we have over predicted the values. So the range of mean squared error can be between minus 10,000 to plus 10,000. So this result is okay, but it could be better by changing the PQ and by changing the order of P, D and Q. You can change the value, or you can try to fix this problem of mean squared error and reduce the error itself. So that's it for this video. If you like this video, please click on the like button. Also share if you have your friends who are studying or want to delve into data analytics. If you want to learn more from DexLab Analytics, you can go ahead and call us on the numbers given on the screen here, or you can WhatsApp us, or you can write us a mail on at hello@dexlabanalytics.com. We are currently placed in Gurgaon. Yeah, so bye-bye, take care, that's it. Have a nice day.